Now, there's estimations that are being made that nearly 14 crore of people have lost their jobs. 80% of those working in urban India have lost their jobs. Now, what is the relief for them immediately? The reason this is important is that if they don't have money to buy, whatever revival package you want to give to the MSMEs, this is basically not a stimulus package. This is a monetary package. It's not a fiscal package. And that stimulus cannot really work because there won't be people who will have demand or who will have money to buy things. You can give as much stimulus as you want in order to produce. But where are the takers for that production? So therefore, first of all, address this concern. That's why we have been saying pay 7,500 rupees a cash transfer to all families who are not non-income tax payers. Distribute free food to all those who are hungry, and to see this tragedy of inhuman tragedy of the migrant workers that is going around. Unless you address these issues and also give financial aid to the states to meet both the pandemic and for the economic revival, none of these packages really can be anything meaningful. The second point is that the crisis in the Indian economy, the problem we are facing today, is basically demand-oriented. There is a very sharp fall in demand or the purchasing power in the hands of the people. Now, making capital available easier, loans available easier, credit available easier to stimulate production will have no meaning unless you are addressing the fundamental issue of increasing the purchasing power in the hands of the people. No stimulus of this nature, which completely excludes employment generation, big public investment programs, building our infrastructure, that is the way in which we'll be able to create an economic revival or kickstart the economy to begin with. But I think this has missed the wood for the trees. The entire issue of this COVID pandemic and the need to battle that is being misused to set in motion another agenda. Right now, the single focus should be the question of battling this pandemic. And in the process, the hardships that the people are facing to resolve them. Now, instead of that, you use this period of national lockdown to initiate reforms, pursue an agenda, which is what you want to pursue. Okay, fine, you're in government. You want to pursue that agenda, which we think is not in the interest of country or the people or the economy. Now, if you want to pursue that interest, don't use this pandemic and people's tragedies in order to bring about these reforms. Now, what are these reforms? Your Niti Aayog CEO said, seize the moment. It's now or never. Now, what is it? You will abolish the labor laws. And you think that without the cooperation of the labor, any economic revival is possible? The Prime Minister talks of saying respect the wealth earners or wealth creators. Wealth is nothing but the monetization of value, and value is created by the worker. And if you don't respect the worker and the working people, no economic revival is possible. What must be your focus? Are you going to save human lives or run after greater profits? Now, what is happening? Have we lost all sense of humanity and all sense of compassion? Now, that is the question I want you to answer. What is this counter? Were there reforms like this brought about when you had the plague epidemic in our country? Were there reforms like this when you had the bubonic plague or the Spanish flu in the world? What are you talking about, Rahul? You use a situation where people are dying when you're not able to contain the disease, when you're not able to provide the basic infrastructure to stop its spread, when you're not able to test what is the spread of this virus in the pandemic in our country, scientifically, what are the steps you're taking to solve the problems of the crores of people who have been affected by this pandemic? Have you ever even thought of forget a stimulus to provide even trains without fares to these migrants who are walking for days and dying on the road out of exhaustion and hunger or through accidents? People who want to stop the train in order to board it to go home are run over by the same train which carries their dead bodies. Lockdown is the period when you utilize that period for equipping yourself. Have we done that? Honestly, tell me, have we done that? Today, our rate of testing is one of the lowest in the world. Our hospital space, along with all the ventilators and all the things, is one of the low. I mean, it's absolutely inadequate. They have only given them greater credit access. It is not anything that is given to the MSMEs. And they said that moratorium, they'll pay on interest payments. If the interest payment is 9%, the government will take guarantee for 4%. They are only giving greater credit facilities. And why will any MSME take credit unless what he produces or what that unit produces can be sold? And the workers' lives, you say, are as important as the MSMEs. Mm-hmm. And if there are nobody there to work for the MSMEs, you want this migrant labor to come back? Are you creating the conditions for them to come back? Will they come back? Do they have the confidence? The alternate plan would be, as I said, transfer immediately 7,500 rupees cash transfer to each family that's a non-income tax-paying family per month for the next 3 months. Generate some demand.
Have you done the max on that? Will you let me give you the alternative? Okay, go on.
You got 8 crore tons, 7.7 crore tons of food grains rotting in your central godowns. Can't you distribute that free? Where will that money come from? It's already there. Can't you distribute it free for people who are going hungry today? 10 kilos of these food grains per individual for the next 6 months, every month, can't you give? You have more than that, the stock lying there. So it's not that there's no dearth of resources in the country. The question is, where is it going? Which are the corporates? Tell me, Rahul, you're also an employee, or maybe part owner, part employee, whatever it is. I'm not going into your personal status. That's not the issue. But the corporates which are today retrenching jobs, doing pay cuts, aren't they one of the most handsome contributors to the Prime Minister's fund, the private trust fund?
Sure.
Are they not?
Sure, they are. So what's the point?
Then why are you sacking your employees when they have no alternative to live? Where do you begin?
That's the point. Where do you begin?
I would begin with the people. That is the priority for any government, any country. The welfare of the people is my priority. And that is where you should begin. And if the people are healthy and they are able to deliver and work, then the economy can revive on the basis of the other packages you can bring. But this is missing the wood for the trees, as I said. The problem is demand generated, lack of demand. You are giving supply incentives. How can anything succeed in this?
Okay.
Give all the incentives you want to the MSMEs. Let them produce.
But can it not?
Who will buy? With you, with your pay cuts, will buy? The United States of America tests more than 30,000 people per million. We are testing 1,166 people per million. The more you test, the more are your cases. That has been shown in every state. Wherever the testing is higher, the cases are higher. Wherever the testing is lower or just not being done, it's an excellent state. There's not been anything. And today you saw that reports that are coming on the mismatch of the number of people dying and the number of COVID deaths that are being reported. You go to your crematoriums, your Shamshan Ghats, whatever you call them. So, I mean, come on, Rahul. I mean, let us be realistic. We are not living in some sort of a dream world. If you want this real world to improve, the real people have to survive.